Bill Maher kind of gifted us a little bit of a topic this weekend. I don't know if you guys got to catch this early, because I watch real time every now and then, but every once in a while, one of his monologues will circulate on Twitter and make the rounds, and that's how you know it's getting some coverage or some talking points. But Bill Maher made headlines over the weekend with his closing monologue on real time that addressed the Oscars, on which he opined the Oscars should be called the Debbies, giving the Best Picture nominees are all fairly upsetting films. Now, it's true, there is a weight to all these nominees. I've seen all of them. And it's not the most uplifting slate of movies. And before you say of all the years where they could have made these movies so downtrodden, you got to think they didn't foresee a pandemic. They didn't foresee a pandemic year, if nothing else. But to bill them all as depressing, I think cruelly misses the point of many of these movies. I think the bigger issue is the fact that we've gone from griping about the Oscars not being diverse enough to the Oscars not being happy enough. We got to find something to be, we have to
Hey,
find something to
I
complain.
tack on to one I will tack on to one argument. I will not tack on to Bill Maher's Mars here, so sorry, keep going.
Yes, fittingly, the clip that went viral on Twitter, which is where people go to bitch and moan about problems while offering no solutions. So I guess that was only reasonably fitting that it went viral on Twitter. But maybe it's the fact that these films came out during one of the darkest times in the world, so we noticed it more. But not all the nominees are seriously depressing, and I had to laugh at the closing kind of compilation of classic Hollywood movies.
Oh,
Such
wait till we get there.
uplifting movies like Gladiator and Schindler's List
And
and
12 Years a
Titanic.
Slave.
Yeah, like the Oscars have always been drama centric, maybe to a fault. I would even say to a fault. The year where you could have highlighted escapism, it might have been better. But I also think too, I will say he does tap into a couple things, because I do think this is a noticeably downtrodden year for the Best Picture nominations, not in terms of quality, but in terms of just general plot, and just general themes. It's not a very uplifting slate of movies. So I kind of agree on that. And I think number two, though, I think you can't deny the lack of fanfare for the Best Picture nominations this year. There really hasn't been a ton of buzz. And maybe it's the lack of theater going on the last year. Maybe it's the fact that all these nominations are on different streaming platforms, so not everybody's totally sure where you can find these movies. Maybe that's it, even though you think, ironically, the ease of access would make them more topical. But I think that there is grounds to consider that might be the case. Dominic, what say you about Bill Maher's rant?
Well, look, out of all the late night hosts, I think Bill Maher is objectively the worst. Like, just on the level of smarminess and so I'm not talking about like Fox News or MSNBC. I'm talking about like late night hosts, right? And I cannot stand, okay, obviously objectively I was joking, but like I cannot stand Bill Maher, and I'm a pretty left-leaning guy. Potentially more than Bill Maher. But he's just like how he delivers things is truly the worst. And it's like, dude, you're making all the arguments you're making for the left-leaning and occasionally progressive causes worse by talking about him in this way. I've never really been able to stand him as a comedian either, just on that. I don't know. There's something really off-putting about it. Not in a way that John Oliver might be, not in a way that Seth Meyers, and a lot of people really hate Seth Meyers, and I get it to a degree. But anyway, just that on that level, it kind of irks me. But overall, yeah, dude, like this could not be more of like an old man yells at art he doesn't understand, or like
Just
he
art he
didn't,
doesn't even see anymore, too. Like, it feels like a
Yeah,
very
this is
much an
like.
outsider's view of like what the best pictures are this year, or how Hollywood's been like the past 10 years.
Like, this is such a Karen take. Like, what are you talking about? Like, yeah, I get it. It could be argued that this specific slate of best pictures happens to trend maybe a little bit more depressing, right? And then it also on top of a particularly nasty year. But it's like, dude, overall, this is yeah, Steve mentioned it earlier. Like, you're really gonna admonish how we went from Oscars so white to now Oscars so sad. Like, what kind of dumbass take is this? Like, Judas and the Black Messiah, that is like radical, dude. Like, the fact that a mainstream studio bankrolled the story of Fred Hampton and it was a good movie, and now it's nominated for Best Picture. Like, dude, that is like, you should be happy about that. But out of all the late night shows, he's just irks me the most, and he feels like the griftiest out Literally, of all. I haven't really watched too much of him, but just because I can't stand him, but he just gives me those bad vibes. But like, I mean, Trial of Chicago 7, that's a fast paced movie, dude. Yeah, it's Sorkin. So like, I don't know, I can go through all of these, but Joe, please stop before I go old man yells at old man, please.
Bill Maher, like, he's a guy that I watch from time to time. I don't necessarily hate the guy, and like, I like most of his stuff. I actually kind of like. I do like watching his show late at night on HBO Max, or when I had HBO Now.
I agree
as
with
well.
His points of view off him.
No, like, yeah, and even this, I see where he's coming from, but this is like judging a book by its cover. Basically, is the way I'm looking at this. It's like he didn't watch any of these movies, and he just went, "Well, what's this movie about? Oh, a woman got raped and was murdered." It's like, that's not the premise of Promising Woman. Like, yeah, a woman got raped, but she didn't get murdered. She committed suicide. And, like, there's a whole different thing. Like, you're acting like that's the main character. Also, you spoiled the movie, asshole. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Also, like, out of all the movies that you could admonish for being, like, super depressing, like for the topics that Promising Young Woman had, like really weighty topics, it was actually really kind of fun to watch in kind of like a revenge way. Yeah, yeah. You know, and like, I love that toxic scene with the Britney Spears toxic. Like, holy shit, this is awesome. And like, dude, yeah, again, you didn't watch the movie.
It feels like he saw Nomadland and went like, I guess every movie this year is going to be like this. Because it's like, that's how he just judged all the nominations after he talked about Nomadland. So, like, real quick, I actually wrote down, he goes through a list of movies. He's like, why can't Hollywood make movies like this anymore? And it's almost like, dude, are you not realizing what I say? Full Metal Jacket, the horrors of the Vietnam War that it did to people and that country. 12 Years a Slave. Do I really need to talk about, like, how depressing that movie is? Do the Right Thing. Oh, yeah, a movie where a black guy gets murdered by the police at the end of the movie because he can't breathe. That's not topical or relevant to the lives that we're living today. Schindler's List, Nazis and Jews, like, come on.
And it's not Jojo Rabbit.
And I'm going to get to Jojo Rabbit in just a second. He also just overlooks a lot of the movies that came out this year that I feel like a ton of people were talking about, specifically three movies that all ended up on our best of list in some sort of way. Palm Springs was one of the movies I like talked to so many people about, and they were loving it on Hulu. Soul on Disney Plus. It's an animated family feature. It was so heartwarming to receive that at the end of the year. It was perfect for a Christmas time movie. And then finally, the movie that got nominated for Best Adapted Screenplay and Best Actress, Borat Subsequent Movie Film. It's a Borat sequel, man. I wasn't depressed while watching that. And then my final thing is, and I'll throw it back to either Dom or Steve. He also goes on to say, like, oh, it's been like this for a long time. Well, I went back to the 2020 nominations for the year of 2019. These are the movies that got nominated for Best Picture, or even like Best Directing, Best Adaptation, Best Original, or Best Animated. We have Ford versus Ferrari. That is not a depressing movie. That is a very entertaining, energetic sports film. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. That is a very fun movie. Watching Leonardo DiCaprio and Brad Pitt just hang out and then end up killing like the Mason people at the end of the movie. Wasn't depressed while watching that. Jojo Rabbit, literally one of the best comedies I saw last year, probably the best comedy, and it's about
could not be the more inverse of Schindler's List.
Yeah, and it's about with the same topic who wants to be a Nazi soldier in Germany. Yeah, and it's really funny and heartwarming somehow. Like 1917, a grand adventurous action film. Toy Story 4, an amazing animated film, along with How to Train Your Dragon 3 and Claws. And then finally, Best Original Screenplay. One of the most fun times I had in the theater with an ensemble cast, Knives Out. People ate that up Thanksgiving weekend. It's like, this dude, like, I don't know when the last time you've been to the movies is. Like, it's just like the way he's talking about it, it's like, let me just hammer on this point for just this year and make it sound like, oh, it's always been like this, except back when I went to the movies, when it's like, well, you put on 12 Years a Slave, homie, and that came out in 2012. That's not that long ago. Anyway, Steve, go on.
Yeah, and I was just going to list a bunch of movies. You took a lot of them, actually. There was a lot of escapist fare this year. King of Staten Island, Eurovision, A Secret Love, even the Netflix documentary. Yes, God, Yes. You had Bill and Ted Face the Music.
Oh, my God, yeah.
You had Happiest Season. You had even Unpregnant. I know we had mixed opinions on it, but that's kind of it's a, you know, talk about taking a heavy topic.
Compared to the one that you
talk
watched.
About a heavy topic. Talk about a heavy topic with a feel-good sentiment or a feel-good kind of ambiance to it. You know, so there's absolutely that. And the Oscars, and this is a whole other issue, the Oscars have been historically, I would say, I'm trying to figure out the right word here. I promise I'm not, or at least in this case, I'm not lagging. They've been historically inept in honoring comedy. That's been the Oscars' problem. For many years, but they've always been drama centric. And yeah. Joe, even going back last year, you didn't have these weighty, dense dramas and such. Now, like I said, Sound of Metal isn't the most uplifting movie on the planet. We'll talk about it soon. The Father, I cried like a fiend to The Father. That's a hot, heavy one. But you didn't have those. You didn't have, you did not have as downtrodden affair as I think Bill Maher makes it out to be.